My name is Baton Haynes, and I'm director of the Duke Human Vaccine Institute. I'm here today to discuss the results of our recent paper, An Autoreactive Antibody from an SLE HIV Individual Broadly Neutralizes HIV, that was recently published in the Journal of Clinical Investigation. Mattia Bonsignori is the first author on the paper and was the prime mover of this work. In addition, we had terrific collaborators shown here from Duke, Dartmouth, Boston College, and the NIAID-NIH Vaccine Research Center. Developing a vaccine for AIDS is a global priority, and I am fortunate to lead a large group called the Chavi Immunogen Discovery Group here at Duke to tackle this problem. The HIV outer coat or envelope is the target of protective antibodies and has several conserved regions on it to which antibodies can bind. Only rarely, though, chronically HIV-infected individuals can make antibodies to these regions, and when they do, they're called broadly neutralizing antibodies because of their ability to neutralize many diverse HIV strains. One of the main roadblocks to HIV vaccine design is our inability to induce broadly neutralizing antibodies with a vaccine. So the problem our paper addressed is why we cannot induce HIV broadly neutralizing antibodies to the conserved regions of the HIV envelope, and when these antibodies are rarely induced in chronically infected individuals, why and how are they made? As a background to our study, in 2005, we reported in Science magazine that two of the three then HIV broadly neutralizing antibodies were also autoreactive with host proteins and lipids, and we hypothesized that the reason broad neutralizing antibodies are infrequently made is because this autoreactivity of these antibodies led to deletion by immune tolerance controls. That is to say, the body recognized the autoreactive broad neutralizing antibodies as potentially detrimental to the body and turned them off, thereby preventing them from being actually made. In autoimmune disease, where many autoantibodies are frequently made, it's been found that when autoantibodies are made in autoimmune diseases such as systemic lupus erythematosus, it is because of defective immune controls of autoantibody production called defective immune tolerance. Also about this time, we noted that rheumatologists had suggested that individuals with systemic lupus erythematosus had a disproportionately low incidence of HIV infection and speculated that this low HIV incidence in SLE was due to lupus patients' abilities to make a better quality anti-envelope antibody than individuals without autoimmune disease due to lax or faulty immune tolerance controls that occurred in SLE. Interestingly, now that over 100 new broadly neutralizing antibodies have been isolated by the field, it's been found that all of these antibodies have one or more of the following unusual antibody traits: autoreactivity, high levels of somatic mutations, and long antibody combining sites called HCDR3 regions. The common thread among all these traits is that antibodies with these traits are frequently downregulated or deleted by immune tolerance control mechanisms. Over the years, we've searched for and now have found one systemic lupus erythematosus patient, or lupus patient, who was also chronically infected with HIV, to determine if this person could indeed make broadly neutralizing antibodies. Our paper in the Journal of Clinical Investigation describes this individual with SLE and HIV infection. Remarkably, this person has been infected for a number of years, but has controlled their viral load and never needed antiretroviral therapy. When we studied their plasma antibodies, we found indeed they made broad neutralizing antibodies. And mapping of the plasma neutralizing antibodies by our colleagues at the NIH Vaccine Research Center showed that these antibodies were targeted at a site called the CD4 receptor binding site. Mattia Bonsignori and his team at Duke then used single-cell or clonal memory B-cell cultures and high-throughput screening of the culture supernatants to identify an antibody called CH98 that neutralized 63% of primary HIV strains. As is common in lupus, the HIV-infected SLE patient had plasma autoantibodies present, including double-stranded DNA antibodies that are part of the criteria for SLE diagnosis. Like other broadly neutralizing antibodies, the CH98 HIV antibody had very unusual traits in that it was extremely mutated with 25% nucleotide substitutions. And remarkably, the CH98 broad neutralizing antibody itself was autoreactive with reactivity to double-stranded DNA. The cross-reactivity of the broad neutralizing antibody with double-stranded DNA was very surprising to us and provided support for the hypothesis that broad neutralizing antibodies indeed are quite similar to the autoantibodies that arise in lupus patients that are not HIV infected. In our other studies of knock-in mice in which broad neutralizing antibody genes have been knocked in, Laurent Vercozzi and our group at Duke has found that the good news for vaccine developers that not all B cells making neutralizing antibodies are deleted. Rather, he's found that a small number of remaining B cells make it out of the bone marrow to peripheral lymph nodes and spleen, and there can be activated by vaccines to make plasma broad neutralizing antibodies in this mouse model. However, this work has taught us that the pool of remaining B cells from which broad neutralizing antibodies develop is very small, called a subdominant B cell response. So for help with the vaccine development effort, our studies in the SLE HIV individual have shown us how similar broad neutralizing antibodies are to typical autoantibodies that are controlled by immune tolerance mechanisms. From this work, we've realized that the precursors of broad neutralizing antibodies are rare and subdominant, and therefore vaccine regimens are being designed to specifically target the subdominant broad neutralizing lineages in order to selectively drive these lineages to become sufficiently dominant such that plasma neutralizing antibodies can be made. Now, not all autoreactive antibodies are detrimental or harmful to the body, and we believe that the HIV antibodies can be induced in a safe manner. We call these regimen designs B-cell lineage immunogen designs, whereby immunogens are designed that optimally bind at each branch point of a desired subdominant broad neutralizing lineage. Our study of this SLE patient with HIV infection has been critically instrumental in our understanding of the unusual biology of this remarkable host control of antibody responses to the conserved broad neutralizing sites of the HIV envelope. We're quite hopeful that these insights in lupus will aid to our implementation of strategies of B lineage immunogen designs that will result in experimental vaccines that can overcome the host tolerance control of these disfavored but helpful broad neutralizing antibody responses. Mm-hmm.